I cannot enter. William Bishop. Must be the same strain. This sickness moves faster than influenza. It's locked, all right. Balls of Mars, fortifiers. As popular as they are ineffective. But they do contain iron tartrate, and that might prove itself useful. Let's go.
It's locked.
I cannot enter. This key will surely grant me access to the basement. These skulls feed from corpses and the husks of animals. They're not after blood. It's locked. Mr. Connor's injuries don't match the report. I'd better look into this. I'm not sure I can defeat them without becoming stronger. To drink blood is so tempting. It's locked, all right. Good evening, nurse.
Good evening, Doctor. I don't think we've been introduced yet. My name is Pippa Hawkins.
And I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. Dr. Swansea has recently offered me a position in this hospital.
Well, it's a euphemism that your help will be appreciated, Doctor.
Goodbye, Nurse Hawkins. traces of a pinkish foam at the corner of the lips. Some sort of drug overdose, perhaps? The chest was originally open to perform the operation. The sutures are clean. The chest has been reopened. Multiple abrasions and scarring on the arms and legs. Old and distinctive injuries of a sailor or a fisherman. A puncture over the left lung, possibly a chest tube insertion. Not the cleanest work, but I think it was successful. Signs of internal bleeding. So, Dr. Tippett's anesthetics were incorrectly dosed, causing the patient's death. And then he tried to operate on him again. Tippett has made an egregious error. It's time we talked.
We can handle this. know I can count on you. I wish I could say that.
Good evening, sir.
So it is true. The famous Dr. Reed has joined us. I can't think of any better news during these terrible times.
Do we know each other?
Actually, yes. We met once before, at the Rockefeller University in New York.
Dr. Tippett's, yes, I remember. I was assisting Professor Carell in his research about coronary bypasses. He had nothing but praise for you.
He was also very confident about your future. And look at you now. Eminent surgeon and blood transfusion specialist.
What is the Pembroke Hospital situation? And please, speak freely.
This hospital is not exactly the best of London. I'm sure you are used to working in a better environment.
It's not exactly the best situation in London either. I can't have expected this hospital to be prepared for what was to come.
Don't be misled by appearances, Dr. Reed. This hospital does not lack talented people. It just lacks hope.
What can you tell me about the staff in the hospital?
Some are really good, and others are not so good. But during this troubled period, there is no time for slander. I prefer to focus on the positive character traits.
Tell me more about cherished people, then.
Nurse Branigan is a pearl. She is the most helpful and dedicated nurse I've ever worked with. A clever and cheerful woman.
You really seem to admire her skills.
I'll go even further. If she was a man, she would be a damn fine practitioner.
Any opinion about the management?
I don't always agree with Dr. Swansea's reserve. But I must admit, he does all he can to keep this facility running during this crisis.
Ah, yes, the burden of command. I was fed up with this concept while serving as a medical officer.
Don't get me wrong. Swansea's a good administrator. I just wish he would get out of his office down again.
Corin, I want you to tell me about Mr. Connor. How did he die? What happened?
He was my patient. He died because of my mistake. That's the blunt truth.
Who was this patient?
I don't know. Some sick man from the docks. Maybe a fisherman. I had no time to talk with him. No one claimed a body.
What was the nature of the mistake?
It was a twofold error. My diagnosis was wrong, and the administered dosage was too strong.
Why not stop practicing?
Are you mad? I killed that man, I admit it, and it won't happen again. I have saved so many lives since then.
Goodbye, Dr. Tippett.
Perhaps I should have considered the offer from that Cadogan fellow.